Well, guys, the winter months have definitely come for a lot of us. Even down here in Texas, we got some snow on the ground, and it made me think, how does this Honda CRF 250 Rally perform in sub-freezing conditions? Well, the other day, I took it out when it was only 17 degrees, and with the wind chill just standing, I think it was in the single digit somewhere. So on the bike, probably below freezing. And I took it out on a 25-minute ride out to a spot and then brought it back. And the bike did surprisingly really well for what it is. There are a few things that would make the winter riding significantly better, especially on a bike like this. Throw on some heated grips, heated seat, taller windshield, just get a lot of that wind out of your face. I was catching a lot of wind, unfortunately. And throwing on some hippo hands so you keep your hands warm. That was the biggest thing for me, was just how cold my hands were. But that's also a side of just not wearing the right gear. But yeah, it's definitely unfortunate when you just have to park your motorcycle and not ride it for a few months. I'm a type of person that I just try to ride it, you know, all year if I can. And luckily in Texas, that's normally pretty possible, but you definitely run into these sub-freezing temps. So I was like, I gotta see how this bike performs. And luckily I didn't have any slippage on the tires. There were a few times where I saw ice on the road, but just had to navigate around that. Just ride really gentle, easy on the brakes, easy on the throttle. I'm trying to think what else. Handling was great. With the wind though, there was some strong gusting wind. You definitely get pushed around a bit on this bike, even at like 45, 50, 55 miles an hour. You're getting a lot of wind. So, you know, probably above 60, 70, it's gonna be really difficult, especially in sub-freezing temps. It's just gonna be a little bit sketchy for sure. One thing that I think would help this bike a lot is these OEM foot pegs. I'm not a huge fan of them. I feel like you don't get a lot of grip. And in these sub-freezing temps, you wanna make sure you have a lot of confidence whenever you have your feet on those pegs. They feel a bit slippery. It feels like your foot can just go right off of them. So maybe replacing those with some really aggressive pegs would be great, make the riding a lot better. But yeah, unfortunately today is probably not really safe because as you can see, I don't know if my foot, but it's really slippery. So I wouldn't trust these tires today, especially with drivers in Texas. Not the best reputation whenever conditions get bad. So probably not gonna ride it today. But yeah, if it's just a dry, hard cold, I think this bike does just fine in sub-freezing temps. Just make sure you prepare yourself as best as possible. Wear the right gear, that's the number one thing. Just going with the right mindset. You can't ride aggressive when the temps get that cold. Put on a much bigger windshield would have saved me. Some hippo hands would have definitely helped. Heated grips, heated seat. And then just things to make you more confident, like much grippier, you know, more aggressive knurling on the pegs. And that's pretty much it. Other than that, the bike did pretty good. And if you're in really cold states, I'm sure people put on some ice tires. You get the little spikes in the tires and you could probably go ride on some ice or frozen lakes. That'd be a lot of fun on this bike. But yeah, I just wanted to make this video. We don't see snow a bunch in Texas, so great time to make a video about riding in sub-freezing temperatures on the Honda CRF 250 Rally. Definitely not a bad bike to do it, especially if you don't have much ice on the road.